it was because of some unavoidable circumstance.
Imran Ahmed Khan Niazi versus Mia Muhammad Nawaz Sharif.
See, on 20th of April, two of us had rendered our final opinions. Three of us had deferred their judgment, and then after conducting some proceedings, judgment was reserved on 21st of July by three of us. And first of all, today their lordships will announce their judgment, which will be followed by an order of the court. So I request my learned brother Ijaz Afzal Khan to announce the judgment as far as the three honorable members are concerned.
A sequel to what has been discussed in paragraphs 7 to 11, following directions are made. National Accountability Bureau shall, within 6 weeks from the date of this judgment, prepare and file before the Accountability Court, Rawalpindi, Islamabad, the following references on the basis of material collected and referred to by the Joint Investigation Team in its report and such other material as may be available with the Federal Investigating Agency and NAB having any nexus with the assets or which may subsequently become available, including material that may come before it pursuant to the mutual legal assistance request sent by the JIT to different jurisdictions. A. Reference against Mia Muhammad Nawaz Sharif, respondent number 1, Maryam Nawaz Sharif, respondent number 6, Hussein Nawaz Sharif, respondent number 7, Hassan Nawaz, respondent number 8, and Captain retired Muhammad Safdar, respondent number 9, relating to the Evanfield properties. Dates number 16, 16A, 17 and 17A, Evanfield House, Park Lane, London, United Kingdom. Preparing and filing this reference, the NAB shall also consider the material already collected during the course of investigations conducted earlier. Reference against respondent number 1, 7 and 8 regarding Aziziya Steel Company and Hill Metal Establishment is indicated above. Reference against respondent number 1 and 7 and 8 regarding the companies mentioned in paragraph 9. Reference against respondent number 10 for possessing assets and funds beyond his known sources of income is discussed in para 9 above. NAB shall also include in the proceeding all other persons, including Sheikh Saeed Musa Ghani, Kashim Masood Qazi, Javed Kiani, and Saeed Ahmed, who have any direct or indirect nexus or connection with the actions of respondent number 1, 6, 7, 8, and 10, leading to the acquisition of assets and funds beyond their known sources of income. NAB may file supplementary reference if and when any other asset which is not prima facie reasonably accounted for is discovered. Accountability Court shall proceed with and decide the aforesaid references within a period of 6 months from the date of filing such references. In case the Accountability Court finds any deed, document or affidavit filed by or on behalf of the respondents or any other person to be fake, false, forged or fabricated, it shall take appropriate action against the concerned persons in accordance with law. As a sequel to what has been discussed in para 13 above, the following declaration and direction is issued. It is hereby declared that having failed to disclose his unwithdrawn receivables constituting assets from capital FZE, Jabal Ali UAE, in his nomination papers filed for general elections held in 2013 in terms of section 12.2F of the Representation of People Act 1976 and having furnished a false declaration under solemn affirmation, respondent number 1, Mia Muhammad Nawaz Sharif, is not honest in terms of section 99F of RUPA and Article 62.1F of the Constitution of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan 1973. Therefore, he is disqualified to be a member of Majlis-e-Shura Parliament.
Silence, please. Silence, please.
Silence. The Commission of Pakistan shall issue a notification disqualifying respondent number 1, Mia Muhammad Nawaz Sharif, from being a member of Majlis-e-Shura with immediate effect, whereafter he shall cease to be the Prime Minister of Pakistan. The President of Islamic Republic of Pakistan is required to take necessary steps under the Constitution to ensure continuation of the democratic process. The Honorable Chief Justice of Pakistan is requested to nominate an Honorable Judge of this Court to supervise and monitor implementation of this judgment in letter and spirit and oversee the proceedings conducted by the NAIP and the Accountability Court in the above matters. This Court commends and appreciates the hard work and efforts made by members of the JIT and their support and ancillary staff in preparing and filing a comprehensive and detailed report as per our orders. Their tenure of service shall be safeguarded and protected, and no adverse action of any nature, including transfer and posting, shall be taken against them without informing the monetary judge of this court nominated by the Honorable Chief Justice of Pakistan. We also record our appreciation for the valuable assistance provided to us by Mr. Naeem Bukhari, AC, Khwaja Haris Ahmed, Senior AC, Mr. Salman Akram Raja, AC, Dr. Tarak Hassan, AC, Mr. Tufail Tofiq Asif, AC, Sheikh Rashid Ahmed, Petitioner in person, and Mr. Ashtar Osaf Ali, Attorney General for Pakistan, Mr. Vakar Rana, Additional Attorney General for Pakistan, and Mr. Akbar Tarar, Acting Prosecuting General, NAIP, and their respective teams. These petitions are thus disposed of in the terms mentioned above.
Now I'll announce the order of the court. Now that all the 5 members of this bench have already recorded their own respective judgments, we are ready with the order of the court. And this order of the court is essentially based upon the unanimous opinion recorded by 3 honorable members, which order has the operative part has just been read out by my learned brother. The National Accountability Bureau, NAIB, shall within 6 weeks from the date of this judgment prepare and file before the Accountability Court, Rawalpindi, Islamabad, the following references on the basis of the material collected and referred to by the Joint Investigation Team, JIT, in its report, and such other material as may be available with the Federal Investigation Agency, FIA, and NAIB, having nexus with assets mentioned below, or which may subsequently become available, including material that may come before it pursuant to the mutual legal assistance requests sent by the JIT to different jurisdictions. Now, these are the references which have been ordered to be filed. Ref A, reference against Mia Muhammad Nawaz Sharif, respondent number 1. Maryam Nawaz Sharif, Maryam Safdar, respondent number 6. Hussain Nawaz Sharif, respondent number 7. Hassan Nawaz Sharif, respondent number 8. And Captain Retired Muhammad Safdar, respondent number 9. relating to the Evanfield properties, flats number 16, 16A, 17 and 17A, Evanfield House, Park Lane, London, United Kingdom. In preparing and filing this reference, the NAB shall also consider the material already collected during the course of investigations conducted earlier, as indicated in the detailed judgments. B. Reference against respondents number 1, 7 and 8 regarding Azizia Steel Company and Hill Metal Establishment, as indicated in the main judgment. C. Reference against respondents number 1, 7 and 8 regarding the companies mentioned in paragraph number 9 of the judgment unanimously rendered by Mr. Justice Ejaz Afzal Khan, Mr. Justice Sheikh Hazmat Saeed and Mr. Justice Ejazul Hassan. D. Reference against respondent number 10 for possessing assets and funds beyond his known sources of income, as discussed in paragraph number 9 of the judgment unanimously rendered by Mr. Justice Ejaz Afzal Khan, Mr. Justice Sheikh Hazmat Saeed and Mr. Justice Ejazul Hassan. E. NAB shall also include in the proceedings all other persons, including Sheikh Saeed, Musa Ghani, Kashif Masood